Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Applied Forensic Research Sciences. I am Shruti Kharnar, volunteer of Applied Forensic Research Sciences, here with the topic Henry's 10-digit classification of fingerprint. The content which I am going to share today is introduction, then the basic primary classification, followed by secondary classification, sub-secondary classification and final classification, and how we are going to completely represent this Henry's classification. And then the next one is references. So starting with introduction, let's first of all discuss what is fingerprint. Fingerprints are the impression left by our fingers on any surface in contact. These fingerprints are unique as well as they can be classified. So because of presence of this unique characteristics in the fingerprint, Sir Edward Henry made the official introduction of an use of fingerprint for criminal identification. In 1986, he also developed a fingerprint classification system, but it is also said that he covertly gave his name to the classification system worked out by his Indian employees Khan Bahadur Azizul Haq and Rai Bahadur Hem Chandra Bose. This developed system of classification helped in classifying the fingerprint, for which during the classification, we required the fingerprint card which is shown on the slide. Then, this recorded fingerprint card has the fingerprints which can be classified according to the Henry's classification system, which consists mainly of four major classes. First one is primary classification, next one is secondary classification, followed by sub-secondary classification and final classification. First of all, let's discuss the primary classification. In this classification, we are considering all the fingers of our hand and considering the values which are numerical for the whorl pattern. These numerical values are as mentioned in the slide, for which we are giving 16 and 16 values to right thumb and right index. Then the right middle and right finger are given with the value 8. Right little and left thumb are given with the value 4. Left index and left middle are given with the value 2. And left ring and left little finger are given with the value 1. Which means that when the whorl pattern is present in any of the finger, that is even it is in right thumb or even it is in left middle, we are giving the values which are mentioned here. In the case where the pattern present in the finger is arch or loop, we are assigning the null value, that is 0. So let's consider the example where we have right thumb as a loop pattern, left right index as a whorl pattern, right middle as a whorl pattern, right ring as a whorl, right little as a whorl, left thumb as a loop, left index as a whorl, left middle as a whorl, left ring as a whorl and left little finger as a whorl. So here we have to give the value according to table to the whorl pattern, and wherever is the arch or loop pattern, we are giving the null value. After assigning the values as mentioned in the image, we have to do the primary classification, where we are placing the even fingers in the numerator and odd fingers in the denominator, which means that primary classification is equals to numerator upon denominator, in which numerator consists of right index, right ring, left thumb, left middle and left little finger. Then in denominator we have right thumb, right middle, right little, left index and left ring. Then we have to place the value of each finger. Then we have to add those values. After adding those values, we have to add 1 to numerator as well as denominator. After complete addition, we get the value of primary classification. So consider the case where we have whorl pattern present in all the fingers. Then the value of primary classification will be 32 upon 32. And in the case where we have the primary classification value is 1 upon 1 is when all the patterns are either loop or the arch pattern. Next one is secondary classification. Here we consider only the index finger of both the hand, that is right index and left index. In secondary classification, we also place it in the form of numerator upon denominator, where we place the right index in the numerator and left index in the denominator. So, we have to check the patterns present in the right index and the left index. If the pattern is plain arch, we have to denote it by A. If it is tented arch, it is denoted by T. If it is ulnar loop, denoted by U.
If it is radial loop, it is denoted by R and whorl pattern is denoted by W. So for example, let's consider the right index has central pocket loop, which is a pattern of whorl, and left index also has a central pocket loop, which is pattern of whorl. So the secondary classification value will be W upon W. Third major classification is sub-secondary classification. In this, we consider the index finger, middle finger and ring finger of the both hand, which are assigned with the alphabetical values when they contain the loop pattern or the whorl pattern. And if they contain the arch pattern, then the null value is given. Consider for the loop pattern. In case of loop pattern, the ridge counting is done. For the index finger, if the ridge counting falls between 1 to 9, then the alphabetical value is given as I. And if it is 10 or more, then it is given as O. For the middle finger, if the ridge count is between 1 to 10, then the alphabetical value is I. And if it is between 11 or more, then the alphabetical value is O. For the ring finger, if the ridge count is between 1 to 11, then it is denoted as I. And if the ridge count is between 12 or more, then it is denoted as O. Next one is for the whorl pattern. In case of whorl pattern, we do the ridge stressing. Ridge stressing is performed in whorl pattern and based on the ridge count between the right delta and the tracing end. The ridge stressing value is given as I if the tracing end is inside the right delta and the value of ridge counting is 3 or more. Or it is denoted as M if the ridge stressing value is 3 and it is inside or outside the delta or it is less than 3. And it is denoted as O if the ridge stressing value is 3 or more and the ridges are outside the delta. Then this given value are put in the form of numerator and denominator for considering if it is given as right index, right middle and right ring in numerator and left index, left middle and left ring in denominator. Therefore, consider the example where the right index has the pattern central pocket loop and its ridge stressing value is I. Right middle has the central pocket loop and its ridge stressing value is O. And right ring has the central pocket loop and its also ridge stressing value is O. And similarly, for left index, it is central pocket loop, its value is O, left middle, its value is M, and left ring, its value is I. So, in form of numerator and denominator, the value of sub-secondary classification is I, O, O, upon O, M, I. The last step to complete the hindrance classification is doing the final classification. So, in the final classification, we consider the little fingers of the both hand, that is right little finger and the left little finger. If they contain the whorl and the loop pattern, they are assigned with the ridge count value and rest others are given the null value such as arc pattern. The ridge counting is done for the loop pattern in the general rules. But for the whorl pattern, for doing the ridge counting of the left hand, the right delta is considered. And for doing the ridge counting of the right hand, the left delta is considered. Then after performing the ridge counting, the right little finger is placed in the numerator, whereas the left little in the denominator. So final classification is written as right little finger upon the left little finger. So consider the example where is right little having the plain whorl pattern and where left little is also having the plain whorl pattern. So ridge counting in the right little is 15 and ridge counting in the left little is 14. So the final classification value is 15 upon 14. After completing the four major classification, the complete representation of the Henry-Steingen classification system is done. It is in the form of numerator upon denominator, where first given is primary value, then near to it placed is secondary value, then it is placed sub-secondary value, and finally it is given a final classification value. So it is presented as shown in the picture. The content presented in this slide have the reference from Fingerprint Analysis and Understanding by Mark K. Hawthorne and StudyLib.net. Thank you all, and if you like this video, please do like, comment, share and subscribe. And do visit our channel Applied Forensic Research Sciences. Thank you.